Welcome to pathology department. This is the histopathology section that will be receiving the COVID-19 positive samples separately from that of the other samples. As soon as the OT technician informs that there is a COVID-19 sample which is being sent to the laboratory, the team gets ready to receive it. They have to wear the proper protective personal equipment, and even the person who is receiving has to be scrutinized properly. The form and the sample, both which are being brought to the lab, must be checked and then it will be processed. So we will gradually show how the scrutiny of the form of the sample is done and how the processing of the sample is done in the lab.
आपने चेक किया था ये फॉर्म बाहर अलग से सेपरेटली फिल किया था?
जी मैम.
ठीक है, थैंक यू. डॉक्टर फाइजा, वी हैव रिसीव्ड द सैंपल.
As we see that we have received a sample which is labeled that COVID positive and a requisition form which also shows that it is a COVID positive patient. The sample should be sent in a double leak proof container as seen here, and then one more polythene bag is inside, and we should see the proper labeling of the sample, that is the age, name and sex of the patient, and COVID-19 positive. All the samples should be immersed in 10% buffered formalene, and as soon as it reaches the lab, we have to change the formalene and keep it in the formalene for 24 hours. But if the sample is really large, we can keep it for 72 hours. That is why there is little delay in processing for COVID-19 patients. After that, we do the processing section. Now, this is the specimen which was kept for 24 hours in formalin, and we will just take this for grossing. So, we'll take the specimen. As it is small, a small fragment of it is kept on a filter paper and then is kept in the cassette.
Now this cassette is put in this machine with all the other specimens for further processing of the specimen. We'll put all the PPVs in this bag for discarding. As you can also see, it is mentioned here COVID-19 positive.
COVID-19 is a highly contagious disease. It spreads by touch and contact. Hence, we have to take due precautions of the laboratory personnel so that they do not get infected while handling these specimens. And as there is a chance of spillage, so at least 3-layered containers should be there. And once we process it in formalin for 24 to 72 hours, it inactivates the virus, after which it can be run in the machine along with the other specimens. And when the slides are ready for viewing, these are again non-infectious.